Mustangs, and welcome to the Mustang News in the Morning. I'm Sharon Fonz.
And I'm Danny Ramslin. Thank you, Mrs. Lucas's third period, for participating in our pledge segment.
Heads up, Mustangs, exam week is the start of Tuesday next week, so be sure to start hitting those books. Now let's see what today's megabytes are with Danny.
Choices that you can pick up for lunch today are a chicken Caesar salad, turkey burger with cranberry sauce, or pasta with meat sauce. Don't forget to side your meals with fresh fruits and vegetables. Now let's see what Sharon's up to in the local area network.
Today in local news, new drug laws are being passed to go into effect for Pasco County. Florida has increased its illegal drug use concentration by over 350% in the last 10 years, Pasco County being in the top 10 counties in the state to have this problem. Local synthetic drug shop George's Smoke Shop was one of the 130 Pasco County businesses visited by the sheriff's deputies on Wednesday. Those law enforcement members were delivering warning letters enforcing the newly created ordinance designed to help fight the synthetic drug use and sales. The goal, said Sheriff Chris Nocco, is to help conquer the drug battle that is taking place in our own backyard. Reports are saying that it is easier to get your hands on spice, K2, kush, and even bath salts than alcohol in some areas. In other news, a downtown crash involving a motorcycle has shut down Ashley Drive at Twig Street early this morning. The motorcyclist was transported to Temple General Hospital in critical condition. He was traveling westbound on Twigs when he was struck by a vehicle in the intersection. Police said witnesses told them that the motorcyclist ran a red light, which caused the accident. Now let's see what Lucy's up to in our weather app.
Oh, good morning, Mitchell. This is Naples reporting live for the Mustang News in the Morning. I'm here with Michael Lizzo on the hotspot scene right here now. Michael Lizzo, what is hotspot?
Well, that's a good question, Nate. Hotspot is a game show that I host myself where I basically pull the students and staff of J.W. Mitchell High School and ask them random questions that pertain to local events, world events, and just questions about Mitchell and in general.
Well, that doesn't really sound that hard. Like, I think I know a lot about the school. I've been here for 3 years.
Well, I'm sorry you think you're the world's best game show contestant.
I am.
I don't think you are.
All right, quiz me.
Fine, Nate. How long is giraffe's tongue?
Well, I'd say, based on experience, 21 inches.
I don't know how you got that one right. I really don't know. It's kind of freaking me out. But all right, fine, Mr. Smart Guy. How many cookies does a person eat a year, approximately?
I would say about 34,999.
No, you're wrong. It's 35,000. I don't know how you got that close either. Fine. How long do you think my socks are?
3 inches above the ankle.
Yeah. Wow. Okay.
All right. It wasn't really that hard, but since I can master it. I want to see if other people can master it. How do you get on Hotspot?
Well, that's a good question as well, Nate. To get on Hotspot, you can ask me up in person. I'm not too hard to find. Email me at mikeizzo95@yahoo.com or come see Mr. Whitaker in room 740, and you could be on the newest Hotspot.
Well, thanks, Izzo. Seems like fun. Back to you guys in the studio.
Robbie Thompson. He took this about a week ago out on the docks. It seems like it was late afternoon since the sun looks like it was about to set. Thanks for the wonderful picture though, Robbie. That's all for today, so let's check out what Carly's up to in the sports cage.
Hey Mitchell, it's Carly Dampier here in the sports cage. In NBA news, our Miami Heat now has 14 wins and 6 losses. The Golden State Warriors used a knowledgeable play by a rookie and took advantage of a defensive breakdown to surprise the Miami Heat last night. Draymond Green, a second-round draft picked out of Michigan State, made a layup with 0.9 seconds left to give the Warriors a 97-95 win over our Heat. The update on the NHL lockout, as I am sure all you hockey fans out there are supposed to be watching your favorite teams play by now, but it is still in progress as Katie Strang from ESPN discussed the NHL's decision to cancel all the games through December 30th. Rumors have it that NHL labor talks resume, but no conclusion to process. Last night, our girls' weightlifting ended up coming in second against golf and Hudson. There was a lot of competition, but our girls lifted past golf. Also, a shout out from all the fellow teammates to Elena for lifting 135 pounds. Last night, the boys' varsity soccer team defeated the Ridgewood Rams in a convincing fashion by a score of 5-0. The top goals of the night were scored by Nick Barkis and Brian Herney. Also, the JV boys' soccer team continued its dominance over Pasco County by defeating the Rams by a mercy score of 8-0, just 2 minutes into the second half. Goals were scored by Sean Brilo, Matt Nelson with two, Devin Martin, Ryan Hoskins, Colin Davis, Nelson Morello, and get this, even the goalie, Mike Shore. So it looks like the girls' JV soccer team is doing pretty well. Now let's take a look at their game against Zephyr Hills.
What's up, Mustangs? I'm Lucy DeVillo here at the girls' JV soccer game where they're playing against Zephyr Hills High School. Let's see how it's going.
Kane is in the building.
Mustangs, back to you guys in the studio.
Today in campus news, tonight we'll be having an AP Study Night coffee house from 6 to 8:30 in the media. There will be coffee, hot chocolate, and cookies. Many AP teachers will be there, but be sure to check the school website or ask your teacher if they will be attending. In other news, Mondays and Wednesdays, our school helps in both reading and math from 3:10 to 4:30 p.m. Math in room 521 and English in room 524. If you would like assistance in either of these subjects, Mitchell can help. That's all for campus today. Now let's see what Sharon's up to in the National News Link.
Today in National News, I know a lot of people out there dislike Justin Bieber, but how far would you go? Apparently, a few men in South Carolina disliked this pop singer so much that they formed a murder plot against him. Investigators say that Mike Steak and his nephew Tan Ruan had every detail planned down, including the ties they were going to use to strangle the pop star and three other unnamed people. The Bieber fever started a long time ago in a state prison near Las Cruz, New Mexico, where Steak met Dana Martin, a convicted killer who was serving two life prisons for other crimes. Martin recruited Steak, who in turn recruited his nephew to carry out four murders after Steak got out of prison. All people involved were arrested in Vermont, but because of cooperation and spilling of details, Ruane was let go with no charges. In other news, the Golden Globe nominees list was released last night. Some movies up for some Golden Globes are The Hunger Games, Act of Valor, Lincoln, Life of Pi, Argo, and Diageo Untamed. The Golden Globes will be taking place in January 13th.
Teachers, if you would like your class to be featured on a daily Pledge segment, please email Mr. Whitaker.
Teachers, if you have received a Golden Mitchell Pride ticket from your teacher, they can be dropped off in the wooden mailbox that is located in the lunchroom. It is on the closest side to the admin building. Thank you for tuning in to the Mustang News in the Morning. I'm Sharon Bontz.
And I'm Dana Ramsey. Have a terrific Thursday.
They say he was made of snow, but the children know that he came to life one day. There must have been some magic in that old silk hat they found. For when they placed it on his head, he began to dance around. The Frosty the Snowman was as live as he could be. And the children say he could laugh and play just the same as you and me. The snowman knew the sun.